Hey you guys, it is me, Laura, and today I am sharing with you how I lost 30 pounds in about 5 or 6 months. So before I get started, I want to address the fact that this video has been really hard for me to make. And I know that might seem weird, right? It's like a weight loss video and I'm telling you what I did. How is that hard? But it's been difficult because I know that there are a lot of people that are going to be watching this that have been struggling with weight in very different ways. Maybe you have always felt really bad about the way that you look. Maybe you feel like you have low energy, or maybe you're struggling with health problems as a result of your weight. Maybe you're trying to gain weight. Maybe you're struggling with an eating disorder from overeating, bulimia, anorexia, unnamed eating disorders, or various other things. And I know that there are so many people who are going to be watching this or have clicked on this for so many different reasons, and it is because of that that I have really struggled in sharing this. So let me tell you right now that I am approaching this from the perspective of encouraging health. That is what weight loss is all about to me. So what I'm going to do, this is going to be a little bit of a longer video. Just after thinking a lot, I feel like it's important to share a little bit of my story before I share how I lost weight. I will put in the description box below some timestamps. So if you are not really interested in my story at all and you just want to know how I lost weight, you can jump ahead to that. Go ahead and grab a cup of tea, pull your chair up, or go ahead and put your headphones on and listen for a while, because this is a longer vlog and a little bit different from what I usually have. But just to give you a start, ever since I had my boys in pregnancy, I was very sick. Well, even before then, I kind of struggled with my weight. But then, especially after they were born, my health was just struggling massively. I had diastasis recti, which I will link to a video more about that up here. And I also had pelvic floor issues, pelvic floor prolapse issues. And when I was pregnant, I had hyperemesis gravidarum. I spent a lot of time in bed, so I was really weak. And I just really struggled with both of those pregnancies, recovering, and had a whole lot of issues there. So that's kind of where I was at. And on top of that, I struggled with postpartum depression with both of my pregnancies, and a big contributor to that was the huge issues that I was having with breastfeeding and with my recovery issues and combining it all together. But I've also been someone who's generally struggled with depression in my life. So we had a huge family change where we packed up our whole family, everything that we knew, we decided, and 3.5 weeks later we moved across the country from Tennessee to Idaho. We left family and friends and moved somewhere where we don't know anybody, and have had a different climate, have been great outdoors, and we've missed people. But overall, the move has been really good for us because the climate change immediately had positive effects on my health. Moving from a very damp, humid, hot climate to a dry climate made a huge change. Not only that, but just the climate being the way it was, our whole family was outside more, we were getting more active, which was great. Having a little bit more space and not so many things going on and people that we knew, my husband and I have both kind of had time to reflect and think and pray and do a lot of things that we hadn't been doing. During this time, it was also a difficult transition for me because I had moved from having someone who lived with us who was there to help with the boys and the family and everything to here I am now having to do it myself. My husband still works at home, but he has to work, and so we knew nobody. So I had nobody to depend on. So I was kind of flung into this situation of, okay, this is a big change. And as I was looking at my health and as I was looking at everything and evaluating like how to do better, I realized that one of my biggest problems that was affecting the family was my depression. And I finally decided, like, I am done with this. I am not going to allow this to ruin my family, to ruin my life, to rule our family anymore. So I decided at that point that I was going to do what it took to battle depression, whether that meant taking medication, whether that meant going to seeing counselors again, what work it could do on my health and my life, and that I knew that having vitality in my life and being healthy, like, I really just, the hardest thing for me was that I felt like I was letting my family down and my kids down, and that I wasn't being the mom and the wife that they needed, because I was just so depressed all the time. I was on the couch. I wasn't able to do much and interact much. So I knew that my biggest thing was that I had to have vitality in my life. Now, I've dealt with this before, and I know enough to know that exercise is a huge piece of that puzzle, but I simply did not have the energy I needed to do the exercise I needed. And on top of that, from my diastasis and from my pelvic floor prolapse, I had major, and this is even after going to physical therapy for nearly a year, probably combining after both pregnancies more than that, but I didn't have the energy that I needed to exercise, and I knew that this was a problem. And based on some dietary limitations due to my own food intolerances, and my oldest has several food intolerances, I knew that I was struggling with some dietary needs. And so, even before I really started doing that, I did find a workout program that I could do. There were still a few modifications that I needed to make, but for me that was huge, and that was Pio. And it's a Beachbody program, and I found out about it and did some research online, and found on YouTube there were some samples of it, and I knew what my limitations were, and this was within the realm. And there were a few exercises, it was low impact, like everything I needed. There were a few exercises that I still couldn't do, but when those exercises came up, I would do my physical therapy exercises in that place in the workout. But I got the program in, and I just didn't have the energy to keep up with it. So I knew that I had to look at my diet, and I was doing some herbalism training at the time, and was looking at a whole bunch of dietary things that would make a difference. And I, based on blood work and other things, I started realizing what I needed to supplement. One of the things that, after working with a nutritionist for a while, I knew that needed to be improved was protein in my diet. And we had talked about how to improve that, but I was having a hard time implementing all of the things that we had discussed. So I wasn't getting enough protein. B6 complex I was struggling with. There were several other things, and just on a basic level, there were several herbs that I knew that I needed based on my own body constituents and the needs that I had. So I researched, and adding all of this and working with all of this and doing all of this was going to be crazy and expensive, and all of a sudden I found Shakeology, which I had heard about before and wasn't too sure. I am not someone interested in drinking shakes or doing meal replacements or anything like that. I am a firm believer that you eat your nutrients. You need to eat your nutrients. But as I was looking, probiotics, huge. I have not found a probiotic I've been able to tolerate. Shakeology had probiotics in it. It was vegan. It had the protein in it that I needed, but it was balanced with the carbohydrates, which was a really good way for me to get what I needed. It had the exact same herbs that I needed. Like, it had everything in it that I knew that I needed to add to my diet, except for the B6 complex, which is easy to add. So I talked to my husband and I said, all right, I think this is where I need to try. If it doesn't work, okay, but if this can give me the energy that I need to exercise, then it's totally, totally worth it. So we ordered it. Well, I ordered it as a challenge pack because that made the most sense, and I talked with a Beachbody coach, and I went ahead and signed up as a coach just so that I could get the discount on my Shakeology every month. And when I got my challenge pack, it came with, I got Beachbody On Demand, which is it's got a bunch of extra workout programs, plus it had the Pio, which I'd already purchased, and I could get it on my phone, I could get it on my computer, and all of this kind of stuff. And then it also came with portion control containers, and I thought, you know, I'm never ever going to use those because I know that I eat really healthy already, but it's cheaper to get it this way, so I'm just going to do it. So I started drinking Shakeology, and within a week, I felt so different, like, my energy levels were already improving. And I saw the containers and I just thought, you know, I'm curious about what their program is for eating and if it's any good at all, because I just have always been interested in nutrition and different nutrition plans and learning about each of them. So I started measuring my food, and you guys, I was shocked to realize how few vegetables I was actually eating. Here I am, a vegan who's really focused on healthy diet and healthy eating, and I was not eating many vegetables. I was shocked. So then I thought, this is interesting. So I started following the meal plan and measuring out my portions, and I realized that the portion control that they had was not exactly right what my body needed. I was paying really close attention. So I tweaked it just a little bit and found where I felt optimally healthy and like how I felt good, and it was just amazing. So then I started exercising because I was already drinking the shake. I was feeling better. I was measuring my food and I thought, well, why not? So I started doing Pio and I did it straight for 60 days. During this time that I was starting all of this, my husband was gone. Like, that's how easy the containers are. He was gone on a business trip and I'm here with the kids by myself. And still was able to do it. And so I said, okay, I'm gonna do Pio, I'm gonna do it for 60 days, and I am not gonna give up. And because of my coach who was encouraging me, and because of the energy that was going on from other Beachbody coaches, I did it. Like, we were traveling during that time. I did it every single day. I did one of my workouts in the airport using Beachbody On Demand, which is totally not like me, but I felt good and was able to keep this up. And then after Pio was over, I was able to try some other things. I did some weightlifting with Shaleen Extreme, which I never thought I would do weightlifting, and I loved it. I tried some things I didn't like as well, that just weren't right for me. I tried size, but with kids in the house, it was just too hard because you have to really focus on the moves, and I couldn't do that. And a lot of times with my workouts, sometimes I wouldn't finish a workout because I'd start and I'd get 10 minutes into it, and the kids would just need too much, and I couldn't finish. But I did as much as I could, and even that 10 minutes every day was better than none. And there were some days that I would just be doing a 20-minute workout, but it would literally take me an hour to get it done because of all the times I had to stop, take care of the kids, do what I needed to do. But I just really learned that the key was doing something every day, because if I stopped, starting again was just so much harder than just keeping going. And so I did every day, just did some. And you guys, I went from not being able to pick up my, at the time, 2-year-old to, because it hurt too much and because I didn't have the energy, I didn't have the strength, to now I'm able to pick up my 6-year-old and my 3-year-old at the same time, walk down the street with them, and not have any problems. I can be with my family, I can be active with my family. I will never probably be able to run a marathon. There's some high impact things that I probably will never be able to do. But I am doing things that I never dreamed possible. My energy is higher. Like, I am there for my kids. And my depression, it's just a whole new world. Like, do I still have low days? Yes. Do I still struggle with depression a little bit cyclically, monthly, from women hormonal issues? Sure. But it's not the deep, dark depression that I had before. And ultimately, this has been about health. And during the process, one thing that has been important to me, I was overweight. And I knew that part of being healthy was being at a healthy weight. So that has been kind of one of my goals, like to keep me going and to keep me motivated to exercise, has been getting to my healthy weight. So I did that. I've lost 30 pounds and I am now smack dab in the middle of my healthy weight range. And that it's great. Like, do I feel like I look a little better? Sure, but like, I think there's always going to be things that are wrong with my body. I mean, I've had 2 kids. I'm not going to have a perfect body. Like, that is not the goal for me, and I feel like that can't be the main goal, because our bodies are always changing, and there's always going to be someone better looking to compare ourselves to. But just knowing that, like, I want to be there for my family. I want to be healthy for my family. I want to be able to not be limited by depression, by my physical limitations, by my weight. I don't want to have all those extra health issues that come with being overweight. Like, I really just want to be able to be there and enjoy my kids, give them everything I can. And so that has been my motivation, and it has been an amazing journey. And for me, it's about health. Like, I see people talk about losing weight, and it's very quick fixy, a lot of times very unhealthy ways, and it kind of makes me sad, because to me, that's the whole point of weight loss, is to be healthy, is to be vibrant, is to be alive. I wanted to share with you some of the things that I've done to lose weight in a healthy way. Now, I don't expect that these will work for everybody, and I feel like there's a few keys that I want to share with you before I even go more in detail. I know I've kind of mentioned it, but so the first thing that I want to share with you is that there's not one right way to do this or one wrong way to do it. There are a million different diets, dietary choices, dietary things, dietary options, high protein, low protein, high carb, low carb, low fat, high fat, like all these different kinds of options, vegetarian, paleo, vegan, like there's a ton of options out there. And I feel like the key is not in one particular right way of eating. The key is listening to your body and paying attention to what your body needs and adjusting based on that. I feel like that is so, so, so important. So if you are eating and you're not feeling satisfied, play with it. Like, if you're eating based on your plan, add more protein, take away more protein, add more carbs, take away more carbs. Just play with it and see where your body responds the best. And that is so, so, so important. The second thing is take small steps. I've seen so many people try to make these sweeping changes, and it's too much all at once, and they might do well for 1 or 2 weeks, but then they burn out. But you know what? Even if you're just giving up a soda every day, like you're saying, I'm going to drink one less soda every day, and you do that for a month, that's going to be way better for your health than completely overhauling your diet for 1 week and not doing anything else. Like, you've got to take baby steps and do it one step at a time. And you know, if you're like me, if you're a mom and you have little kids, like, it is hard, it is overwhelming, but don't beat yourself up because you can't do it perfectly. Do what you can do. Like, that is so important. And the third thing that is really important is to find what works for you in regard to exercise. That might be going for a jog every day. That might be, you might be someone who needs to go to the gym for that accountability. You might be like me. I hate going to the gym. I hate working out with anyone. I want to do it from the comfort of my home, where I can roll out of bed and get it done, and it can go wherever it needs to fit in my day. And even within, like, if you're doing a workout program or a gym routine, like, do one that you love. Don't do one that you hate. Do one that you like. Do one that you enjoy. If that means you have to try a bunch of things or change it, like, do it. Do what you need to do. Some days I have some kids workouts, and some days I pull those out so that the kids can be entertained and can be doing stuff, and I do those with them. Like, just do what works. Doing any activity is going to be better than none. Seriously. So those are the most important things. But with that in mind, the four things that I did that were really effective for me, the four elements of my weight loss, were: number one is increasing my water intake. Basically, you should be drinking, you should take your body weight and divide it by 2, and that's how many ounces of water you should be drinking every day. So if you weigh 150 pounds, 150 divided by 2 is 75. So you should be drinking 75 ounces of water a day. And so that just, I think the baseline is 64 ounces. So regardless of your weight, you should at least be drinking 64 ounces a day. And by increasing your water intake, that will automatically decrease your hunger some. A lot of hunger signals that we get are thirst signals, and it just kind of gives your body that base weight that will clear out your skin. It will actually help you lose some water weight because your body won't be hanging on to that water so much. So super, super, super important. This is actually one of the hardest ones for me. I struggle with it. I don't know why. It seems so simple, but it is so important. The number two thing that I did was that I started exercising. For me, that was Pio, and I found Pio works really well. I like Shaleen Extreme, but just exercising, doing anything is so, so, so important. Number three, the third thing that I did was my portion control. And portion control can be as simple as paying attention to when you're full and stopping, eating slowly. Like, these are all have to do with portion control and managing. But for me, measuring them out and seeing what was there was just so eye-opening for me. And I find that a lot of times people will do portion control by counting calories. And while for some people that can be helpful, and if that's good for you, that's great, I find that a lot of times what people will do is they'll count calories, but they're not eating foods that are very nutrient dense. They're not eating foods that, like fruits and vegetables and whole foods, that are really going to give your body a lot of nutrient fuel. And so instead they might eat things like, for example, 100 calorie Chips Ahoy snack pack, which, yeah, that's only 100 calories, so that seems great, but that's 100 wasted calories because you're really not getting any nutrients out of that. Whereas if you ate an apple, for example, instead, you'd be getting a whole lot more nutrients and a whole lot more of what your body needs. It's all about feeding your body. You know, I kind of look at calories as like a bank. Like, you get paid every day in calories, and it's not an exact number, but a range, and you want to get the most nutrients out of those calories as you can. It's not about getting the most food out of those calories as you can. It's about getting the most nutrients out of those calories as you can. So a sale in this nutritional term is like a food that has tons of nutrients and not many calories. And these are going to be a lot of your vegetables, a lot of your fruits, your whole foods is where you're going to get a lot of those packing in of things. But I think really kind of finding a portion control, you know, find a diet that appeals to you, start there, and then kind of work your way, tweak it, change it, find what works for you. But really being aware of your portions is super, super important. The fourth thing that I did was I started drinking Shakeology. And Shakeology is a complete meal replacement shake. And what it does is it ensures that you're getting a lot of good nutrients. So even if you have a day that you're not eating super great, you're still giving your body what it needs. And so a lot of times what people will do when they exercise is they will increase their exercise, which increases their body's nutrient needs, but then they'll be decreasing their calories, and along with that, decreasing the nutrients that their bodies need. And so this causes a lot of cravings and makes it hard to keep it up. But what Shakeology did for me, and it could, you know, do potentially for, if this fits along with what you're looking for, it could decrease your cravings and help you feel more full and really fuel your body in ways that give you energy and help you to do better. So those are the four things that I have done, the four things that have helped me to lose weight, and I'm continuing to do those things. I have to admit, it's harder now that I'm at my goal weight, because I'm finding it hard to find measurable ways to continue to push myself. But that's something I'm working on. You know, we're all a work in progress, all kind of on that journey. And if this is a journey that you're on, I would love to encourage you along your way. I really like hearing people set their goals and doing my best to encourage them to reach them. And ultimately, only you can do this for yourself. Nobody can do it for you. But if you want a cheerleader in your court, I'm happy to do that for you. And I also wanted to share with you guys, I know it's New Year's, and I know a lot of you are thinking about this stuff right now. And like I mentioned, when I joined, I did sign up as a coach. Now, I want to say right away, yes, I'm a Beachbody coach, but no, this is not a business for me. I'm not doing this because I need income or because I want income, although it'd be awesome if I got to the point where I didn't have to pay for my shakes anymore. But like, I know a lot of people do this like as a job, and that's not what I'm doing this for at all. I'm doing this because I love encouraging people and because it has been such a positive influence in my life, in my confidence, in my health, in my depression. And I want to help other women have that too, because I see how much it affects our whole family. So, you know, whether you purchase anything or not, reach out to me, because I want to encourage you, whether you are interested in doing anything Beachbody related or not, please let me encourage you and support you. But I did want to share, because I do feel like it is important to know, there is a special going on right now through February 27 of 2016, and this is the first time they've done anything like this. And my understanding, and I could be wrong on this, but is that you can only get this particular discount through a Beachbody coach. So if you know a coach and have already been working with a coach, please go through your coach. Don't, you know, go through them. But if you don't and are interested in this, they're offering 1 month of Shakeology plus the portion control containers and system plus every Beachbody program that they've ever made, including any new ones that are going to come out in 2017. For a whole year, you'll have access to those on Beachbody On Demand, which you can do on your phone, you can do on your computer, anywhere you have access to internet, you can stream Beachbody On Demand. And they're doing that whole package for $200, which is really a really good deal. And so you'll have access to all of that for a year. And they've also got it with a 30-day money-back guarantee. So if you get to the end of 30 days and you're not happy, even if you've had all of your Shakeology, you can get your money back. So I'll put a link with more information to that there. If you're interested in that, please let me know. Know that if you're like me and you're just searching for things, I know one of the things that I really appreciate about having Beachbody On Demand is that I can try a bunch of different things. And if my mood changes, like there's always something there for me to work out with. And that's been really, really helpful for me. So that is my journey. I would love to hear about your journey and your goals and where you're at in this. And again, I know this is a really long video and it's not typical of me, but I know a lot of people are thinking about weight loss around New Year's time. And I want you to know that it is possible. Don't beat up on yourself. I want you to be encouraged by gaining health. I don't want you to be discouraged by feeling like you're not good enough. So I felt like it was really important to share this with you and to let you know that I want to support you and I want to encourage you and to share some tools that may work for you. But if you have been on this journey and you've lost weight, I'd love to hear things that have worked for you. Share in the comments below and others can read those as well. And if you're struggling, definitely, you know, what's your biggest struggle? What have been your roadblocks and what are your goals for the new year if they're related to health, wellness, weight loss, any of that? I would love to hear. And I also wanted to share with you guys that I am going to be on this channel doing monthly challenges. And they'll be 4 week and just small challenges like drinking water or eating more vegetables or doing things like that that will go throughout the year. To encourage all of us, because like I said, sometimes this can seem so overwhelming, but even just tiny little changes can make a big difference. I look forward to sharing those with you because I feel like, as you know, like you see on my channel, I'm learning mommyhood and seeking balanced vitality, and I feel like health is such an important part of balanced vitality, such an important part, but it's a part that we as moms often overlook because we're taking care of everyone else. And it seems like such a challenge and so difficult. So I want to help encourage you in that way, encourage you to take care of yourself, and encourage little tiny steps. So anyway, I want to thank you if you're still sticking with me at this point. This has been a very long video, and it's one that is near and dear to my heart, and one that I know many people will relate to on some level. And I just want you to know that, Mama, you're doing great. Just keep going, and you'll get there. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.